Good to see you back again. New playlist ahead. Let's go! I bet the next experience we have in store will knock your socks off. Guys are the real deal. Their philosophy that cars are for everyone, combined with their electric energy, makes their content stand out like, I quote, a buff horse in a pasture of ponies.
I got a question for you guys, and buckle up, Buttercup, because it's a doozy. Freaking lightning, baby! Listen up, you buff horses. I've got 7 questions that you need to answer by getting behind the wheel of some of the most iconic cars the world has ever seen.
Here we go.
Boom! The car world is made up of rivalries and unanswered questions. You need to settle them once and for all.
More power, baby!
Will it be easy? I don't think so.
That's why I love it. He gives the people what they need to hear.
Lightning, 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 lightning!
And in the end, I need you to answer the biggest question of them all. Who rules the streets?
That is the most badass thing I have ever heard of.
More power, baby!
This is Rule the Streets. Rolling! Let's see what's coming up. We're not staying in Honolulu just yet. We'll be joining the donut team at the bottom of the mountain. They need you to conduct a special experiment before settling down in the city. I'm not gonna lie, James wants to start big here.
Ferrari and Lamborghini have been rivals since they were babies.
It's true.
But don't look it up. Before we set up camp downtown, you'll be racing through the countryside in the Italian supercar of your choice, either the Ferrari F12 Maranetta or the Lamborghini Huracan. Which beast owns the mountain? The Italian stallion or the Stromboli bully?
The Lamborghini machine, let's ride.
James here. I'm talking to you from this drone. Well, I'm not actually in the drone. That would defeat the entire purpose of a drone. That would be a helicopter. It will follow you the whole time and take some awesome shots for our videos. Not in a weird way. Anyway, have fun. Automobili Lamborghini versus Ferrari. Man, I am so pumped. Hey, no pressure, but these cars are like really expensive, so try not to crash and burn, okay? It really makes you think. I should have mentioned there's gonna be turns. Sorry. Down there. Not having second thoughts, are we? Full Italian power! Give me the gravy, Grandma!
No time to rest on your laurels. Keep going, driver. Now that you've met the donut team, you probably have a better idea of what you're getting into. But trust me, you're still in for a few surprises. From now on, the city's going to be your playground. And your first urban challenge will be a rough-and-tumble American street brawl. I can't tell you much more right now. We agreed that James will be the one to give you all the details.
All right, tough boys and girls, you think you've got muscles? Well, how about you take it to the streets in a Chevy Camaro ZL1 or a Shelby Mustang GT500 to find out
who's got the biggest American muscles? Spoiler, it's me.
The Camaro ZL1. Go get that dinner.
Car's natural habitat, the concrete jungle. How's it feel? Didn't think muscle cars could turn like that, did you? All right, if anyone asks, I taught you everything that you know. Flex that car's muscle. I'm flexing right now, you just can't see it. Beepity boop 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 boop. Sorry, that's just the drone talking. He's very excited, don't mind him. I used to live in that building. Who's got the buffest American muscles? Let's find out. Watch out for that curb.
Driver, new challenges lie ahead. enjoying the ride with Donut Media so far? Let's dive even deeper into their world then. Workshop, you'll be driving the oh-so-lovely Nissan 370Z Nismo.
Nothing is more iconic than low car. Except for high car. In this time attack, you'll get to drive both 370Zs for one lap each on the same track to find out for yourself what the difference between cheap mods and expensive mods really is. Can you beat your own time switching from low car to high car? Show us then. Does more expensive mean more better?
I mean, yeah.
No.
Definitely.
Doesn't.
We did it in real life.
Shot. Let's see what you can do with that setup coming straight from the sail rack. Give it the beans! Next time I'm calling you a cab. Do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. Yo! Fully upgraded. Let's rip. Okay, we've done the whole part switching thingy, brakes, tires, suspension, exhaust. Only the best for my baby. Here comes the straight line. Time to put that Nismo high car to the test. Punch it! Focused on driving right now, but I just want to call out that I'm doing a really good job flying this drone. It's my first day. Nail it. Expensive mean more better?
job, but the journey is far from over. As you know, we're sticking to urban terrain for the next event, but we're kicking the intensity up a notch. Motorfest has provided Donut Media with two incredible cars. And knowing James, you can be sure they'll be put to good use.
Motorfest gave us two hypercars with more power than anyone would ever need. Choose between the Bugatti Centuriace and the Koenigsegg Jesko and race through downtown Honolulu. Which car will set the new downtown speed record? And who will split an order of shaved ice with me? Hey, can we get some shaved ice on set?
Oh yeah, good luck.
Koenigsegg Jesko, bold choice. Bold. I meant bold choice.
Motorfest comes with some pretty sweet perks. Check out these two spaceships they lent us. This car is too fast. You are a psychopath. I love you. Drives faster than this. After the docks, how about a little tour of the countryside? Neighborhood. Pretty sure you're ruining the property values, though. Agree that you guys are destroying the previous downtown speed record, but which car's gonna set the new record? The suspense is killing me. I gotta sit down. Kilometers per hour in the city? I don't know, that's gotta be at least 100 miles an hour. Right there! More power, baby!
job, driver. New challenges lie ahead. Our new destination, Diamond Head. Let's set forward. No time for surfing. Time for drifting. To give you one hint, you'll be driving one of James's all-time favorites.
Now's your chance to get sideways, muchacho. You'll be drifting this Mitsubishi Lancer Evo X up and down the corkscrew. The only one you're competing in this challenge against is yourself, just like in life. Can you get all steezy with your slide? And how long can you maintain your drift?
Go drift, my friend. Go drift to your heart's content. This place is amazing. It's like a playground for drifters. You know, that's what they say about Los Angeles these days. Lancer Evo. My friend said it was the fastest car that he's ever driven. What's up, Dan? I bet you never thought you'd be in a video game. Can you drift as long as the Kentucky Cobra? I gotta know! This is gonna make a dope video. You should subscribe to Donut Media. I'm serious, go do it. Well, welcome to the Drifter's World.
No time to rest on your laurels. Keep going, driver. Going fast brings incredible sensations for sure, but no need to reach extreme speeds to get a proper challenge. Meaning? Well, you'll have sensations for sure, but no need to reach extreme speeds to get a proper challenge. Meaning? Well, you'll have to go to Honolulu Airport and get on the tarmac to figure it out. The team is waiting for you there with a whole different type of car this time. A high-performance pickup truck by Ford, the F-150 Raptor. if you need any help, driver, I am right here. Stand by. Closing in. Gather all your focus and dexterity. You're gonna need it.
So we know you're a capable driver. What if you don't have any brakes? You'll be driving this Ford Raptor SVT, and I say driving, but you're stuck in cruise control and you cannot use your brakes. Oh, and did I mention every lap you get faster? So how clean can you drive when slowing down isn't an option?
Riddle me this, Coneheads. How do you win when everyone's going the same speed? That's right, your cruise control is locked and you've got to weave through a whole bunch of cones. But don't even think about touching them. This is simple. Each cone that you touch gets you a penalty. Make a perfect lap and you get a big old bonus. Imagine each cone is the cutest, buffest horse you've ever seen. You wouldn't run over a horse, would you? Nay, sir. Nay. Well, I guess that's one lap. Good job. I don't know if your robot assistant told you, but I may have forgotten to install the brakes. Sorry, is this truck too big for you? You want a widow baby car to make it easier? Well, too bad! Clever girl. Get it? Get it, like in the movie? Huh? I saw that. You definitely hit a cone. Thank you. as it was for me to watch.
Well done. Let's move on to the following event. This colorful playlist is almost coming to an end. I can't wait to see how the Donut Crews use all the incredible sequences they shot with you. almost ready to wrap up. But before, they have one more challenge for you. One last face-off. A little pure, unadulterated street racing, featuring two cars that embody the world-renowned German savoir-faire. Well, it looks like I've said too much again. Just pretend you didn't hear anything, okay?
Say enough good things about German engineering. I've tried. In this final face-off, two powerhouses battle it out in the streets of Honolulu. Audi R8 Spider head-to-head with BMW M4. Who could ask for anything more? Let's find out once and for all who rules the streets.
Audi R8 Spider. Okay, sure, prove me wrong.
This is the last event, so make it count. Don't worry, we'll still be friends after. This is a lot of fun. Thank you for letting me film you in a totally not weird way. You have nice hands. Watch out, this first ramp is a bit of a doozy. Jules Verne's, we got friggin' flying cars over here. These two German speedsters definitely pack a punch. Hawaiian punch. Is that even from Hawaii? Come on. get us the final answer. There can only be one. The finish line is coming. The finish line is coming. Don't mess up.
There's a reward vehicle waiting for you. This truly was a thrilling ride. But none of this could have been that incredible without your outstanding contribution. That's why a very special car is waiting for you at the container. We got the whole donut team to pick it out just for you. Wanna know what it is? All right then, it's a stunning Chevrolet Corvette C8 with a twist. Time for you to collect. Playlist cleared and ready for takeoff, driver. Playlist cleared and ready for takeoff, driver. The next playlist in our catalogue tackles another key aspect of worldwide car culture: car customization. Motorfest, every single car-related thing gets its screen time. To show you the right way to rethink an existing car design, Motorfest went the extra mile and got in touch with a real master craftsman. Liberty Walk is much more than just a simple trademark. It's actually three different approaches to a common customization philosophy: the Liberty mindset, cars appeal to everyone in the world, and there is no limit to creativity. It's performance and customization without compromise. We'll be right back. Liberty Walk, introduced by Mr. Kato himself.
リバティーウォークプレイリストへようこそ。加藤渡です。この日本からこのゲームでしか楽しめない素晴らしい体験を送ります。30年以上も世界中の車をリバティーウォークスタイルでカスタムしてきました。みんなが驚き喜ぶ LB カスタムカーで日本の伝統を大切にしながら作っています。その作品をこのモーターフェストならではの体験を通じてチェックしてみてください。リバティーオークの世界を旅して、君がトップのその旅を終えることができたなら、僕のコレクションから特別な車をプレゼントするよ。
This is Liberty Walk, a step beyond the boundaries of customization.Let's move on to another activity. Without further ado, the first of the three Liberty Walk pillars, Liberty Works. Kato-san is busy with work, but it turns out we have another custom expert on site. Actually, you already know him.
It's Toji. Remember me? Made in Japan, the pack, the guy with the Evo X? You shouldn't be surprised. It's a Liberty Walk playlist. I'm a customizer. That's all I needed to know. My country is the mecca of tuning. There's lots of things to say. But let's start with this. In Japan, every custo lover knows the name Wataru Kato.Bringing his own style to bear on supercars. That's his thing. the way, your BMW is too dull, and you're in the Liberty Walk playlist, so... let the tuning take over. Front bumper and rear wings, side skirt at ground level, wide fenders with rivets. Got those signature, unmistakable. I'm done talking. Just show me what the car can do.
Congratulations, driver. On to the next one. So, how do you like that modded BMW? Can you feel the difference? It has all the signature Liberty Works upgrades. A perfect way to set the mood. Good news. That car isn't going anywhere. You're taking it again for the next ride. And it's a long one. Plenty of time for you to get acquainted with a true Liberty Walk vehicle.
one more run with these wheels. Try to do it justice. It might end up as the reward for this playlist. Customizing European and American cars like that. Aggressive and radical. Liberty Walk has three pillars with three distinct styles. Here we're going through the works part. Kato's original touch. Classic Japanese craft based on wide fenders applied to the most beautiful exotic vehicles. The other pillars are nation and performance, but let's leave them for later. Style update on your BMW. Let's see. Boosted turbo, tougher chassis, more powerful brakes, and wider tires. Yeah, these guys are good. Don't be shy now, set it free. Isn't over.
Job, but the journey is far from over. Last event of the first Liberty Pillar. we're going to see how these souped-up works customs manage through winding mountain passes. Switching rides this time, we've got a modded Nissan GTR for you. Ready to go? Yep, we're going full Japan on this next event. I'll let Toji take over now. He's not the chatty type, but when it comes to customs, you know, passion awakes. Show them what you've got.
This looks like we've got a Color Me Run kind of vibe going on here. Back to basics for the last works race. A Nissan GTR with an insane body kit. Sozoku, a bad boy thing and clearly the inspiration here. Back in the 70s, Japanese clans loved to make noise and showcase their styles in illegal races. Those cars, it was crazy. Kato knows his classics. Now Sozoku is mostly about oversized body kits. It's meant to be impressive. careful with that car. GTRs are a classic of the Japanese car culture. Aggressive by design, but as soon as they pass through Kato's hands, they become insane bangers. Come on now, finish that race.
Great job, but the journey is far from over. Cars are an adventure, and they're for everyone. That's written in the Liberty Walk DNA. So much so that one of their three pillars is entirely focused on this credo. As it's called, is all about applying the Liberty philosophy to any type of car, from any country in the world. Sports cars, sedans, or small everyday cars, from Japanese cars to imports, from big Mercedes to Mini Coopers. Every single car can become a unique supercar. To explore the second Liberty Walk pillar, Liberty Nation. Your first car, the Chrysler 300 SRT8. Boom!
Around you. Not the kind of car you expect to see at custom shows, huh? Trust me, I know my business. All tuning masterpieces. That's what Liberty Walk call Nation. Doesn't matter if it's a supercar or a sedan, these guys can dress anything up. They want to make their look universal, and believe me, they're getting there. Have been dropped for slightly smaller ones, but I still can't see the gap between the side skirts and the ground. Let's hope there are no speed bumps in this race. Okay, you're in first position. The Chrysler SRT8 is meaner than the regular 300. With a V8 Hemi under the hood, you're more than a basic luxury sedan. That's it. See you on the finish line.
Job, driver. New challenges lie ahead. Have you ever seen a mini supercar? There is a first time for everything, driver. Our next event will show you the kind of impact Liberty Walk can have on cars you wouldn't expect to see customized. Nation is about any car type. Remember, to illustrate our point, we have just the perfect car.
Get on board with city cars if they look like this. When I tell you that these guys can custom anything, Don't worry about the sand. It will take more to spoil that paint. Minis are fashion objects. Renowned designers have worked on this car, always respecting its British style. But a little Japanese touch doesn't hurt, right? Play with the camera. See for yourself. If you want to get into custom cars, my advice, keep an open mind. Look, you're driving a European car, lots of different Euro styles. Look them up. My personal favorite is the German look, lowered to the max, bodywork removed, small diameter rims with a large offset. It's a stark style that stays faithful to the original, kind of similar to what we have here today. Just an example, there are so many types of modification around. Choose a style, add your touch, make a difference. It's the way to go. There's even more on the Nation menu.
Driver, new challenges lie ahead. The Liberty Nation exhibition continues. This time, we've taken a distinguished and refined but powerful Mercedes, turned into a street cred optimized version of itself. Mercedes goes bad, Liberty Walk style.
okay, you're driving a C63 AMG, and Mercedes are a hassle to modify. You want to keep their elegance, but add a little urban style. It's like making your grandpa wear a hat backwards. Delicate. Imposing. To check out the Motorfest custom show, and I gotta say, you festival goers have some imagination. You've learned a lot, so no holding back. Next custom show, you need to show it off. Now show me some proper moves. We'll be right back. This was Liberty Nation. Next and last step, Liberty Performance.
Well done. Let's... move on to the following event. Hey, driver. So we've been through two of the three Liberty Walk pillars. Liberty Works, the traditional fender-based customs made by Kettle-san. Then, Liberty Nation. The unique Liberty customization applied to any car in the world, no matter the type or origin. Now it is time for you to discover the third Liberty line, the Liberty Walk flagship brand, Liberty Performance. Performance takes on the most incredible supercars and gives them some extra flair and a healthy dose of individualism. While Liberty Nation is all about that flashy over-the-top approach, Liberty Performance favors more subtle enhancements to a car's distinct identity. The first custom ride of this segment, the Acura NSX.
For me to customize a holy Ferrari, nobody dared to think about it. Nobody except Kato. He took the car, kitted it out, customized it with his own style, and changed the game. Now everyone wants to modify their more exotic rides. Now are supercars and performance. The look is more subdued, keeps things effective, and retains the original spirit of the car. NSX has a hybrid powertrain. Add all the heavy custom you want. Its speed will still be lethal. Liberty Walk sells body kits for this car. They even make one for the 92 Honda NSX. Remember Shingo? He always wanted to get one of these. Do your job now. Push that engine. Would be crazy about that car.
Well done. Let's move on to the following event. Taking epic supercars and making them even cooler. That's one of the Liberty Walk mottos. Makes one wonder, how do you mod a car that's already beyond astounding, such as a Lamborghini? It turns out that Kato-san loves Lamborghinis, so you might get an answer to that question really soon. Master Kettle would say that it's all about balance, passion, and skill, not to mention lots of creativity. You're here. Buckle up and enjoy.
So like we said, Liberty Walk is going for a different approach with their performance line. Top-end vehicle, different treatment. Light tuning, nothing too distorting. Front and side diffusers that widen the body while blending with the lines. All sublimated by some subversive colors. I'm usually into buff street mods, but man, this is a beautiful job. I respect that. custom Lambo. That takes guts. Kind of fitting, considering the Aventador was upgraded several times by Lamborghini itself. Units in the world. Of those, maybe 10 custom by Liberty Walk. Tops. So you better drive clean.
Driver, new challenges lie ahead. A customized Lamborghini Aventador. Wow, that was mad. Do you think we can take it a step further? I think we can. Of Lamborghini. Then we choose a model that's already been upgraded by the manufacturer. Say, the Lamborghini Huracan. Performante. Track-oriented version of the already incredible Huracan. Even more powerful, featuring additional tech and new design tweaks. Finally, let's give it the Liberty Performance treatment. Mm-hmm. what's waiting for you on the starting grid. I bet you cannot wait to see it. Mark my words, the asphalt will crack under the wheels of this car. Now we've really reached the top. Do you think you're ready?
So you're driving a Lamborghini Huracan Performante with a special Liberty Walk performance flavor. You see where I'm going, right? Yeah, your ride's a killer machine. You've got no excuse. On top of all the Performante mechanical enhancements made by Lambo, they've added some final homemade tweaks. Is the most powerful car in its class, just like all the cars you're racing right now. You're in the biggest league possible. To sum up, one of the most impressive hypercars ever made, with an extra layer of Liberty performance tweaking. You think you'll be able to control that thing? Gonna push that car to its max speed or what? There, the coast is clear. Show me. Path. I'm more used to Tokyo streets mostly at night, but sunny countryside rides, sure, why not? As long as we're driving a Lamborghini. Now drive. performance part. Now you see, the customization world knows no bounds.
What a win! The first of many, I am sure. Well done, driver. You've explored the Liberty Walk philosophy from all angles. Now, just like Kato-san, we're going to need you to take your game to the next level. We want to show you once and for all that the Liberty Walk customs aren't just great to look at. So get in the zone for your last Liberty Walk challenge. The Great Loop. It's the longest race Motorfest has organized so far. These cars can go the distance. Can you?
Motorfest clearly enjoys going the extra mile on these playlists. Actually, this time they're going for a whole 50 miles extra, so I hope you've had your breakfast. Not messing with you. You just signed up for a race that goes around the whole island, the full loop, during which you'll be driving three cars, one after another, one for each Liberty line. As you can see, it starts with Liberty Nation, with the return of the Mini Cooper. Be a long run demanding stamina and focus, so stop listening to me and get into it. how are you holding up? You're about to switch to Liberty Works. Expect a more buff ride and some extra speed. Coming right up. Careful for the swamp. There you go. Back with the BMW M4 Liberty Walk Edition. My firm favorite of the day. Moving to second gear. Go kill it. Thank you. swap is only seconds away. You know what that means, right? Third gear. Hold on to your seat. Back on the Liberty Performance side. With the fastest customized car of this whole Liberty Walk experience, the Huracan Performante by Liberty Performance. You know the car, it knows you. Get in sync and finish this.
Shame in trying again.
be surprised. You kept pace with the pack last time after all. Looks like it wasn't just a fluke.
Make sure to get your vehicle reward, driver. Well, driver, you've even managed to charm the stoic Toji. You had the Liberty spark in you. This was such a frantic run. I'm pretty sure Hawaii has never seen anything like it. Stunning performance, driver. At this rate, you'll soon know the island like the back of your hand. Completed this playlist brilliantly. All you have to do now is drive to the container and get your reward. The BMW M4 by Liberty Walk. That's right. Didn't I tell you earlier that this car wasn't going anywhere? Forget our custom show to show off your best creations. Perhaps you can even rival Master Kato himself. I am quite certain your days as a car customizer are far from over. New playlist ahead. Let's go! New playlist ahead. Let's go! Talk to you later. Car system, back on.